So what is the reduce by key? So it will reduce the elements key by key. So it combines the values of similar keys. So here I have a function, so added or reduced by key, and here you can apply your custom logic. So what I'm doing that x comma y is equal to x plus y. So what does it mean? All the values belong to similar key will be added. So I'm adding all the elements belong to similar keys. So x and y are representing the values belongs to similar key. So in our case, let's say my key is 3, then x will be 4 and y will be 6. Okay, so the output will be x plus y, 4 comma 6 will be 10. So here you can see that 3 comma 10. Now for one thing, since only one element is there, so it will be 1 comma 2. So default value is 0 in case you don't have any key. Sorry, if you don't have any value corresponding to that key. Now what is the group by? So it groups values with the same key. So here you can see that here I am applying a function and here I'm not applying a function. So what does it mean? Just group the values, you don't have to do anything else. Here I'm doing grouping. In this case, I'm grouping the values and applying our custom logic. I can do average, addition, subtraction, division, whatever. So now re.group by key. So it will group all the values with the similar key. So you can see that 3 is a key and I have a group of 4 comma 6. Group all the values of similar keys, 1 comma 2. Map values. It will not work on, so it will deal with the values, pair values. So apply a function to each value of a pair already without changing the key. So re.map values will be x to x plus 1. So it means it will increase the values belongs to a key. All the values will be incremented by 1. So now for key 1, value was 2. But here you can see that 2 plus 1 will be 3. For 3, value was 4. So 4 plus 1 will be 5, so 3 comma 5. For again 3, the value was 7. So it will be 3 comma 7. Value was 6. So 6 plus 1 will be 7. Now keys, return an RDD of just the keys. So if you apply this keys function on RDD, it will return all the keys. So 1 comma 3 comma 3 will be the answer. Values, it will return all the values. So RDD.values, it will return all the values from this RDD, or 2 comma 4 comma 6. Sort by key, it will sort all the values by key. So RDD.sort by key. So 1 comma 2, 3 comma 4 and 3 comma 6, this is already in a sorted order. Join, perform an inner join between two RDD. So RDD.join, so it will join the elements on the basis of key. Okay, now so this is an inner join. So it means if I look into this RDD and this RDD, so what is the common key? Common key is 3. So it will output will be all the values which have keys as 3. 1 comma 2 will be discarded. So the thing is, for this key, if I join this pair with this pair, so output will be 3 comma 4 9. So output will be 3 comma 4 9. Now if I do join from this key and this key, then output will be 3 comma 6 9. Now these are a few examples of map, flat mem. So in this example, you can see that, so this is the in this line I'm creating an RDD over a list. Okay, so I have already said that you need not to have your Hadoop cluster and whatever. You can create RDD over list as well. Okay, in your data structures. So I have a list of element Spark RDD example sample and example. So this representing a list and comma 3. So this representing, what is the meaning of this? This representing that sc.parallelize. This is the syntax of creating an RDD from a list. Okay, yeah, from your collection. So what is saying, this line saying create the RDD over this and break this data into 3 partition. Now whatever RDD will be written by this line, it will have 3 partition. Now when I iterate over this RDD, so in mem function I'm saying that create a pair RDD from this RDD. Now in input I have an element, in output I have a pair element. So what I'm saying, just return a pair and apply and assign a value as 1 for each pair. Okay, so when I iterate this, it will look like at very first it will be a spark, then output will be spark comma 1, rdd comma 1, example comma 1, sample comma 1, again example comma 1. Okay, now this is the another way of writing this line. So you can skip this x here with the help of underscore. So you can see that this complete term is missing here. So this is another way of writing. This x can be replaced by this underscore. So this is the sorted way of writing this. So output will be the same. Okay. Now in the third example, what I'm doing, I'm creating a pair of word and its length. So for spark, this will be 5. So spark comma 5, rt comma 3, example comma 7, sample comma 6, and example comma 7. So this is the output. Now this is the example of flat map. So most of the time for flat map, for word count example, we use this. So let's say this is my list of two elements. So in the first element I have a spark, rdd, and example. In the second element I have sample and example. Okay, and I want an rdd of two partition. So this is the syntax, sc.parallelize. Sc is the spark context, and I want to create an rdd over this element. Now x.map, x.split. So in this x I will have a spark space rdd space example, because this is representing a single element. So I'm splitting the elements, okay, and very third it will be sample space example. So this split function return an array. So this split function return an array of these elements. So is for spark rdd an example, the output will be array spark comma rdd comma example. For the second one, this will be array sample space example. Now here you can see that you are getting two arrays, okay, for these two elements. Now if I want to flatten this result and want to combine everything into a single array, okay, then I need to use the flat map. So if I use the flat map, x.split, same function, that this will return an iterator over these elements. So in output you can see that instead of these two array, everything is combined into a single partition. So I have a spark comma rdd comma example for this element, sample comma example for this element. So this is the difference of map and flat map. So when you want to create a single partition, if I say from all the elements, if you want to combine all the elements into a single one, then use the flat map. And if you want to get the one-to-one mapping, then use the map. So in case of map, I'm getting a one-to-one mapping. For this element, I'm getting a this array, comma, for this element, I'm getting a this array. This is the one-to-one element. In input, I have two elements. In output, I have two elements. But flat map return an iterator. In input, you have two elements. When in output, you have an iterator of five elements. Okay. This is the shorted way of writing. I have already discussed. I can replace this term by the underscore. Now what is the map partition? So this is some advanced transformation. So map partition can be used in alternative to map. Map partition is called once for each partition, unlike map for each, which is called for each element. So let's say if you want to apply your function on complete partition, not on a single element, then use the map partition. Okay, so consider the case. So what is the advantage of map partition? Let's say you want to set a few things. So if I give you an example of map and reduce, so in the map and reduce, you see that in the map setup you always set up the few database kind of thing. So I will explain this in the next slides. Thanks for watching. In the next video, please wait.